Hello, Power BI community. Welcome to the Power BI April 2023 update. My name is Ryan Majitimer, and I'm going to be walking you through some of the exciting features that we have for you for this month. If you want to hear about all the other features we release this month, find more information on our demos, technical documentation, that sort of thing, you can find a link to the Power BI blog post in the description of this video. Well, let's get started. First up is dynamic format strings for measures. This new feature allows you to create a format string that also uses a DAX expression, giving you the flexibility to adjust the format string to a variety of contexts within a report. I'm going to hand it over to Zoe, who's going to be telling us a little bit more about the new feature and demo a common scenario.
Dynamic format strings for measures gives you a way to define the format string used on that measure in a conditional way or based on data that's already in your model. A common scenario that this comes up in is if you're doing currency conversion. So here I have a measure where I am converting the sales amount into different currencies. Now the problem is when I want to see these different currencies, they all kind of show with the dollar sign instead of the appropriate format string for that country. Now I can actually add a dynamic format string to this measure so that it will show them in the appropriate currency format string. So if I come to the format dropdown, I can go ahead and click this new option, dynamic. And when I do that, a left dropdown will now appear, which will can toggle this measure between the measure DAX expression and the dynamic format string expression here. It will go ahead and auto-populate whatever format string was previously on this measure, but you're free to go ahead and change this. This is kind of a helper to whatever DAX expression that's going to output the appropriate format string. So here I'm going to go get the one from my model, and if that's not available, then I'm going to kind of give it back in a kind of default kind of way. So now when I look at my visuals, I can go ahead and change this. And I can see they're now displaying in the appropriate format string. What's good about changing the format string instead of going using, say, a format in the DAX, is it preserves their underlying data type. So they still remain numeric, and they're just displaying correctly now in all the visuals. Now to go back and see, if I'm on this measure, I want to go and edit the dynamic format string. I can come in and use the format dropdown. If I want to remove the dynamic format string from a measure, I can use the format dropdown here and just simply pick any other value that I would like to use here. As this, you cannot undo this action, you'll get prompted, and the dynamic format string is removed. If you're familiar with calculation groups, these are the exact same dynamic format strings that were used that are used there in calculation items, and you can find out more information about that in our documentation, at aka.ms/calculation groups. There is a section here on dynamic format strings that can help you get started. And also another point to note is if your visual is not showing the correct dynamic format string, to make sure you also check that in the values section of the axis, the display units is not auto, but instead set to none. And that will make sure that that dynamic format string comes through without any additional layer brought in from the visual. So here I'm going to go change this one to none, and now I can see it with all the decimal places as well. Thank you.
Thanks, Zoe. Next up, we're going to look at some updates to the new on-object interaction. If you recall from last month, we released the preview of On Object Interaction, which allows you to right-click on a visual to access the format pane and make edits there. Roseanne is going to demo some of the updates to this feature that have come through community feedback.
To address feedback from last month's release, we've updated the behavior of the auto toggle. Now, when a user explicitly changes the visual type from either the top five or the full gallery, we switch auto mode off.
Thanks, Roseanne. Well, that wraps up our feature highlights for this month. Tell us in the comments, what was your favorite feature? Was there another feature for this month that you think we should have spotlighted instead? We also would love to hear what you think of the new changes we're making to these videos. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.